Now, online lead generation was a game changer. It changed so many industries, and your industry for sure. And you've experimented. You were an early adopter of this technology, and you did a lot of experimenting with it. So if you can share some of the lessons in your trials and errors.
Gotcha. Yeah, stubborn. Stubborn. I believe when you get something that works and you try something again later that doesn't work, the fact that you had something that works, you want that feeling again. And that's that infectious part of working on the business I was talking about. I know I can find the new stuff that works if I keep digging. And it's actually fun to do. But most people don't have the time or resources to invest in those things and try them. And they're afraid to. Because there's so much, we're bombarded with stuff as real estate agents. Go online and Google real estate lead gen, or go online and Google the next best thing in real estate. And it's just hundreds of things. What do you choose from? Where do you put your money? And a lot of us, as we make more money, we'll throw it out all of them, and then we decide nothing works, and we get frustrated, and it is frustrating. The biggest thing for me is to know that I have stuff that I continually do that I've tried and tested. For every one thing that we do that works really well, I bet you there were 6 to 8 failures. And that's where most people don't keep going. They'll hit 5 failures in a row and they stop. So the fact that we've already done that, and take the guessing, if you will, out of it, like, you know, you don't reinvent the wheel, that saying, is pretty cool. So we can just give it to you if you want. Now, having said that, you just can't stop. You can't give up. And I think if your mindset, especially as a new agent, is what can I do that's better than the last guy? And it's funny, the new generation coming in of people that are coming in, and they get a lot of flack, these young people coming in, a lot of flack. And I tell you, I love one thing that's a common denominator with the newer, younger generation. And that is that they genuinely have the spirit that they want to do best for people, for other people. I like that.
Their mission is more to serve.
100%. Without money, and they mean seriously, without money. I'm not doing this conditionally. There's no conditions to my care for you. That mindset, there is going to be, in my prediction, a lot of younger team leaders, and I mean mega teams, because they maintain that spirit. It's in their DNA. So if they can do that and combine it with my systems, what I have, phenomenal. They will explode.
And lead generation, like a lot of other elements of the business, require an investment.
100%.
So what agents typically, and I know clients that I hear all the time, is that fear of making an investment. And it may be that someone that's making, you know, $100,000, they have to put in aside $10,000. Or it could be, in your case, you're looking at investments that are much bigger than that. But how do you manage that fear that comes along with having to put out to an investment that you don't know yet if it's going to pay off?
Yeah, that's a great question. When I started, I didn't realize the best investment I could make in real estate was me. I actually thought the best investment I can make is buy bigger ads in the paper, buy billboards. And I almost went broke a few times doing that. And the return was very little for the amount of money I was spending, because they'll take your money, believe me. The best investment anyone can make in this business, without question, because I believe this is the best business in the world, if we do it properly, the best investment is yourself. What can you spend your money on to make sure that your training, that speaker wire, if you will, your training is up to par and beyond? You don't want to be at par like everybody else. If you're perceived as everyone else, you'll get the same results as everyone else. You can't be perceived as better until you're seen as different. So what can I do that's different, right? And then it's up to the consumer or other people that I may want to leverage to be on my team. What can I do that they see as different? Because when you're different, then they'll decide if you're better. And most times when you're trying to be different, if you're really concentrating and focusing on that, it is because you want to be better. So those are key things. If you can do that and maintain that mindset, it kind of unfolds.
And do you still feel the fear now when you have to make investments?
Sure, I still do.
How do you get your mind to keep going and not stop you? Like, how do you not give in to the fear?
Yeah. So, you know, it's really no different now, just with a bigger piece of money to take a chunk and throw a couple hundred grand here this year, as opposed to back in 1990 and, you know, to make 100 grand and take 10,000 and throw it here. The feeling's no different. If anything, I guess maybe it's easier now because I've done it for so long. But the numbers are so big now that I still get that fear, is what I'm trying to say. I think the biggest thing for people is if you could invest in anything, know that you're doing it properly. And how do you do that? Do you just trust all those things that come up on Google? No. Trust in someone or something or a system that's currently doing it in today's market. That's kind of a plug for me. I know it is. I don't mean to sound like a sales guy. But if there's one thing I could have latched onto in 1989, 90, 91, 92, it would have been somebody who said, hey, I run a team currently, and I've got five people that do this, this, and this, and we do 100 deals a year. I sure would have followed them. I absolutely would have followed them, because I would have been able to not reinvent the wheel, make a lot less mistakes, not spend money six, eight times before I found the right place. I would have just done exactly what they're doing.